It is essential for our conflict prevention, management and resolution effort that we fully include the gender dimension, because it's simply another lens of analysis, like the ethnic dimension or the economy, to really understand, especially from a social perspective, what is going on in a particular country. Crisis group main areas of focus as regards gender will be on gender and militancy, women's political participation, and lastly, the gender differentiated impact of conflict. Gender and militancy is an area that has been under-researched. It is basically looking at how discourses by militant groups and governments alike try to manipulate gender identities and gender dynamics for their own purposes, for recruitment in particular. In our work on Boko Haram in Northeast Nigeria, we have shown how women associated with Boko Haram have not just been victims, but in some contexts have actually decided to join the insurgency based on their free will, and that they've had multiple roles, sometimes as informants. In some contexts, they've even joined the militancy. We feel understanding also what motivates men, young men in particular, is important. And that's what we're trying to do, to unpack those discourses, including at the early stages of conflict, so that we can provide relevant recommendations. On women's political participation, we actually try to question the stereotypes that women have no power, that they are completely invisible, especially when one is working on deadly conflict. It's true that many of the situations we work on are heavily patriarchal. We're dealing with conservative societies, and in some instances, women are absent from governance mechanisms. But what we have found is that they are often very active in civil society in particular, and women's groups have a voice. Lastly, crisis group works on the issue of the impact of conflict. Conflict, of course, it has to do with local population, and local population are not gender neutral. We're talking about men, boys, women, girls, and we want to understand how they are impacted in different ways by the conflict. Women are more at risk of sexual and gender-based violence, but in some instances, men are more at risk of being killed. In South Sudan, for example, the levels of sexual and gender-based violence are horrific. But men, especially if they're not party to an armed group, are also at risk when they try to get food for their loved ones. So understanding these different elements, especially in situation of displacement, is very important so that we come up with the right solutions. At Crisis Group, what we want to do is to provide nuances. In conflict, things are really black and white. And to bring in the gender dimension, it's precisely doing that. Understanding the motivations of young men and young women when they decide to join militancy. Understanding the grey areas in relation to discourses by governments and militants around gender, including the issue of gender equality. Unpacking power and what that means, who has power, who doesn't have power, and the sort of long-term solution in order to have stable and inclusive societies. And lastly, being there for those who need it the most. At the end of the day, at Crisis Group, it's about making a difference for those who are affected by deadly conflict. And those who are affected by deadly conflict are people, are civilians. So we need to understand who they are, what they want, and how to support them.